Hi guys, welcome to my channel, Nazi here. So today's video, I will be unboxing this Wox warmer kit that I bought from eBay for this price. I'll just put it somewhere there. And I really love the color. And I chose this color because it looks so feminine. And as you know, we all ladies love pink color, don't we? So yeah, there it is. And there's, I think, instruction how to use it. So it's good thing that it's in English, it's not in Chinese language or whatsoever, so it's easier for us to understand. And to be honest, this is super affordable price. Yeah, I used to use the Veet Oriental Wox, which I also featured it in my channel, and I love that one, but I just love something that, you know, I can warm up so easily and I don't need to keep going back to the kitchen and warm it up again in the microwave. So yeah, here it is. That's what's inside this box. It comes with beadwax. Very lovely colors. There's green and pink. And it says with no strips, high flexibility, easy to wax. And I got 4 beadwax. So there is that purple, lavender, and then like cream or yellow. Yeah, so it's 100 gram each. So I have 400 grams. I thought it doesn't come with the beadwax. So yeah, I don't really, you know, read the description when I buy stuff. So yeah, I bought another one which I got in here. Let's unbox it as well. So yeah, I chose this lavender pebble wax, hair removal wax without strip for professional use only. So I really love, it looks like candy. You see, it's so cute and it's also resealable. Wow. So yeah, let's head on to the box. So yeah, there's spatula, and then there is this part, and there's instruction that you can read if ever you are struggling to operate this machine this pot. So yeah, and there is temperature function, and I don't know what is this for, but let's have a look, shall we? So yeah, this is the pot. It looks like it's a blush pink, not so pinkish, not bright pink, which I really love. And there is the thing to plug it. This is the lid, and there's another lid on top of that lid. Yeah, it's more of a handle anyway. So it's a clear pink. There's 3 holes here. And this is the plug, and it's very useful for this one. And luckily it is not the battery operated wax warmer. So this is the pot. You can actually remove it to, you know, wash once you're done. It's very thin though, so as you can see, there's already dent there, but I don't really mind. It looks so cute. So I'm going to try to use this. It's my first time to use waxing kit like this, and the beadwax. You know, I used to use the Veet Oriental wax with the white strips, and that one is a bit more expensive because you have to pay separately for the strips. Like, it comes with the strips, but it's not enough. So, I keep repurchasing the strips. And let me just figure out what's the use of this paper. I think it's for like that. Just in case, you know, it will leak or something. Or if ever you're going to drop all around, you just have to remove it. And, you know, it's not so much work to be done. As you see, I don't really read the instructions. I'm just trying to figure out by myself. So it could be like that also. Yeah, so that maybe our mixture, the wax, won't go in here on this side. So yeah, let's try it on, guys. I'm super excited to try them on with my hairy legs. It's growing already. So yeah, I really like the wax legs because, you know, when it's regrowing, it feels softer than when you're shaving your legs. So it's like that. There is a light indicator, power on indicator. So I'm just putting this right here. I'm not sure if it's really supposed to be there. So this is my hairy legs that I'm going to wax. And I'll show you after waxing, guys. It's so shame, but yeah. I need to show my legs for you to see how much hair we can remove with this bead wax. If it's easier or if it's less painful compared to bead wax. So there it is. It's already plugged and I can feel that it's already warm here. I'm just going to put it right there just in case it will drip or leak. So let's turn it on. So there is medium and there is high. I'll put it to high for a warmer temperature. And which one are we going to use first? Maybe the purple one because I've got two of this color. So yeah, I'm just not sure how much I should pour, but it's up to you anyway. So that's how much I'm going to put it for now because I'm just going to wax my leg. So yeah, let's see now. So yeah, as you can see, it's already melting. And I will grab one of these spatula. It's so great that they gave generous amount of, you know, spatulas. And not just one or three, two or three. So you can mix it as well. So maybe I need to close it. It's quite cold here in the room, so maybe that's why it's not heating up properly. But it might take a few minutes to melt the wax, so let's wait. So if you see that the lights are off, I think it's normal. It will keep turning on and off while you're warming up your bead wax. But I can feel it that it's warming and it's melting our beads. Yeah, it's slowly melting. So it might take like 5 minutes to prepare your wax. I really love the color. It looks like ube ice cream, if you know ube. Purple yum. Purple yum ice cream, so yummy. Yeah, once it's melted, I think you can start applying it into your skin. And the good thing is, you can just leave it there. And it doesn't matter if it's cold or whatsoever in your room. You don't have to go to the kitchen to warm it up again and again. I hope it's not hot. It's not hot. So I'm just going to try a little. I hope it doesn't hurt. Oops. Ah. It only took out a few hair. But as you see, I really like the texture. And it's not too sticky. It's my first time to use this. I keep repeating myself. Ooh, it really hurts. It hurts, but I can tolerate the pain. Unlike the honey wax, bit wax. I think you have to just do it slowly and yeah, small parts first. Let it dry. Can you see the hair there, guys? I'm just going to finish this and show you the result after, because I think it's going to take a while. As you can see, guys, I added more beeswax as I underestimated how much I can use or how much I will use. This bag is almost finished. I think this one will consume too much beeswax. So that's how much I used for my left leg, and I think that's a bit too much. I used two bags just for one leg, guys, and it takes a while to finish it. It took me like 1 hour. So this is good for you if you're patient. So yeah, that's how messy it is. And I find that my legs have rashes. I don't know if it's because of the beeswax or if it's because it's warm. And I haven't done my other leg yet. So I think I'm just going to shave this one because I cannot be bothered. It's already late here. I thought it will be easier to use than the honey wax. So yeah, overall, I really like this machine. But the beads, I think it will take too much, you know, beads to consume. And you will have to keep buying. So I will stick to my Veet. But I'm going to try to use it here. Hopefully, or maybe I can just transfer it into this jar. But for the beeswax, guys, it's a no-no for me. And at the moment, my legs are itching. As you can see, I managed to remove some of the hair. And I feel like the hair, it's not removing from the roots. So it's like you're shaving it really. So half of the hair was like left inside your legs anyway. So it's useless, time wasted. So yeah, I'm just going to continue and finish this beeswax. So yeah, that's all for this vlog, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And if you have any tip how to use this beeswax, guys, please let me know in the comment section. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. See you in the next vlog. Bye.